Good morning. So in this lecture, we'll discuss graph theory from the scratch. So in the lecture series, I will be following the book Graph Theory by J.A. Bondi and U.S.R. Murthy. So this will be, I will be following this book. So let's start with the chapter one. So in the chapter one, the first thing, what is a graph? So definition of graph. So what is definition of graph? So graph is actually a collection of vertex and edge set. So graph is a collection of vertex set and edge set. So V is, you can also write V is as V of G, means vertex set of G. E is edge set of G. And so here V stands for vertices or vertex set, you can say. And this is edge set. So for example, so let us discuss one example. So if I make, suppose this is a graph and let's make this. So these are vertices. So we can say it is a V1. V2, V3, V4, like this. And these are edges. So you can say it is E1, E2, E3, E4, E5. So if I write the vertex set, it will be V1, V2, V3, V4. And edge set will be E1, E2, E3, E4, E5. Where E1, you can write as V1, V2, E2 as V2, V3, E3 as V3, V4, and E4, you can also write the same. Since it's a multiple edge, or you can say parallel edge, so it will also make same thing, V3, V4. And E5 as V1, V4. Okay, so next we have, so what graph is a collection of, you can say order pair V comma E. So graph is consist of vertices and edges. So next, what is the order of a graph? So what is order of graph? So order of a graph is cardinality of set V. So the number of vertices in the graph. This is called order of the graph. You can say it is a cardinality of V. So that is cardinality of V is order of a graph. Next we have size of a graph. So size of a graph. So size is number of edges. So number of edges in the graph. Okay, so you can write that is cardinality of set E is size of the graph. And next we have, so for example, like we discussed there in the last example, if you see this graph has four vertices and five edges. So you can say the graph has order. So this graph has order 4 and size 5, since it has five edges and four vertices. So the number of edges is size and number of vertices is order of graph. Okay, so next let's discuss a neighbor. So neighbor of a vertex. Neighbor of a vertex, okay, in a graph. So in G you say, so neighbor means So first we can define the adjacent vertex. Actually, if there is edge between any two vertex, so like if I take this graph only, so v1, v2, v3, v4. So since v1 and v2 are endpoints of an edge, let's say e1, so we call v1 and v2 are adjacent vertices. So we can first define adjacent vertices, okay? So before the neighbor, let us define it. So if we have something like we have e1 is equal to v1 comma v2. So edge e1 is v1 v2. So we are line joining v1 v2. So we call then that we say vertices v1 and v2. Vertices v1 and v2 are incident with edge e1. So vertex v1, v2 are incident with edge e1. And we also say v1 and v2 are adjacent edges, or you can say v1 is adjacent to v2. V1 is adjacent to v2, or adjacent vertex to v2. So v1 and v2 are adjacent to each other. So when we have an edge, and having endpoints v1, v2, so we call v1 and v2 are incident with edge e1. And v1, v2 are adjacent edges. So these terms are important. So later on we'll see incident matrix and incidence matrix and adjacency matrix. So there it will help. So now let's define neighbor. Okay. So neighbor of a vertex. So notation is like NGV. So in graph G you say. So NVG is neighbor of a vertex V in graph G. So if you write the meaning, neighbor of vertex V in graph G. So what is definition? So definition will be U, set of U such that U is adjacent to V. So like this notation is for adjacent. So you can write. So U is adjacent to V. So set of all vertices which are adjacent to V. So we call that neighbor. So for example, if we have a graph let's say this. So in the graph we name it V1, V2, V3, V4. Okay. So here if I write neighbor of V1, okay, in this graph. So you see, so V1 is here. So it is adjacent to V4 and adjacent to V2. So V2 and V4 will be adjacent to V1. Then what is neighbor of V2? So neighbor of V2 is V1, V4 and V3, because there is an edge. So you have to just see that there is edge between two vertex, then they both vertices are adjacent. So since V2 has edge with V1, V4 and V3 all. So that's why neighborhood of V2 will be V1, V3 and V4. Again, neighbor of, you can write vertex V3. So vertex V3 is sharing edge with V4 and V2. V4 and V2, the neighbor of a vertex. Then let's define loop. So loop in a graph. So what is a loop? So edge with, so loop means like, let's see first example. So we have graph this. So loop is what? An edge with both endpoints identical. So you can write edge with identical end vertices. Edge with identical end vertex or vertices. Edge with identical end vertices. So we call it loop. So here it is a loop. can see simply. So both endpoints of this A is, this is, so it's V1. Okay, next is parallel edges or multiple edges. Parallel edges or multiple edges. So parallel edges or multiple edges. So how we define parallel edges or multiple edges? So for example, if you so see, so if you have between two vertex, if you find more than one edges, so they are actually parallel edges. So two or more edges with same pair of end vertices. Two or more edges with same pair of vertices. Two or more edges with same pair of vertices. So like you can see here, if I name it E1, the top one and the middle one, suppose E2, and this is the E3. So E1, E2, E3 are E1, E2, and E3. These are multiple edges. So for example, you can see in the graph, E1, E2, E3 are multiple edges, or you can say parallel edges. Multiple edge or parallel edge. Okay, multiple edge or parallel edge. Next, we have null graph. So null graph. So means a graph. So graph mostly we write as order pair VE, V is vertex and E is edge. So vertex set and edge set. So a graph with vertex set as empty set and edge set as empty set. So means a graph without any vertex or without any edge. So this is the empty graph, or null graph, sorry. Empty graph is something else. Let me define empty graph. So both are not same. So in null graph, both vertex set and edge set are empty. So a graph G, which is ordered by VE, in which only edge set is empty. Vertex set may not be empty. Okay. So definition, only edge set, there is no edge. You can say there is no edge. So here in a null graph, we can write a graph without any edge. So means without any vertex or edge. And without edge. So a graph in which there is no edge, there is no vertex. So we call it null graph. Empty graph is a graph in which edge set is empty. So there is no edge. There is no edge. Okay. So there is no edge. It might have some vertices. For example, so this. So we have only three vertices. There is no edge. So this graph is empty graph. This graph is empty graph. And null graph will have nothing, neither edge nor vertices. Okay. So null graph will have nothing, neither edge nor vertices. Empty graph will have no edges. It may have vertex. So next we have finite graph. So finite graph. So name itself suggests. So a graph G, it is VE such that, so number of vertices are finite and number of edges are also finite. Both number of edges and number of vertices are finite. So next we have a trivial graph. So trivial graph, graph is just one vertex. Trivial graph, a graph with just one vertex. So only they are talking about vertex, edge maybe, you know? For example, like the graph with, this is a trivial graph, other may be like this, it has only one vertex, so it may have loop. So these are trivial graph, you know? First example, second example. Finite graph, you know, any graph which have finite number, you can take any graph, like you can take triangle. So it has three vertices and three edges. empty graph you have seen. Null graph you cannot draw because there is nothing. Okay, so actually in this course we'll not consider any null graph. We'll only consider about graphs other than null graph. Trivial graph. Then after trivial we have non-trivial graph. So non-trivial is again non-trivial graph means a graph which is not trivial. Okay, so other than trivial graph, a graph which is not trivial graph, a graph which is not trivial graph. Okay, other than trivial graph, like you can take two vertex like this. This is not trivial. So in trivial there must be only one vertex, but we have two vertex here. So next the term is simple graph. So this is important term. This will come again. Simple graph. So what is a simple graph? A graph without any loop and without any multiple edges or parallel edges. Can I write parallel edges? A graph without any loop or without any parallel edges or multiple edges. So we call it simple graph. Is a simple graph. A graph without any loop or without any parallel edges is simple graph. So for example, you can take this. And you can take any this. So you don't have to put any edge loop or multiple edge. So then it is a simple graph. So some more example you can discuss, like a triangle you can take, this is a simple graph. This you can take, this is simple. This is a simple graph with this. So there is some important type of graph, complete graph. So name is complete graph. So what is a complete graph? So a graph in which any two vertex, okay, you take any two vertex, or you can say vertices. So any two vertices are adjacent to each other. Okay. Means there is always an edge between any two vertex. So then we call it a complete graph. Any two vertex are adjacent. Okay. So for example, and we denoted by KN. So it is denoted by. So it is denoted by KN. So KN means complete graph with N vertices. So for example, if you write K1, so K1 will be what? Just one vertex. You write K2, there are two vertex and each will be adjacent to other. What about K3? So K3, there are three. So all of them must be adjacent to each other. K4. So K4, if you make this. So each vertex is adjacent to the other. K5 you can write. So K5 I write. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, then okay, so each vertex will have, yeah, this is K5. Similarly, you can write K6. So K6, if I write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 4, 5. So each vertex is adjacent to the other. So you have to join every one. vertex. This is a K6. So each vertex is adjacent to the other. Next we have, so this is a complete graph. So a graph in which each vertex is adjacent to the all other vertices. Next is bipartite graph. Bipartite graph. So next we have bipartite graph. So what is bipartite graph? So like to discuss about simple bipartite graph. So we'll discuss only simple bipartite graph. So definition is a vertex set of graph G can be partitioned into X and Y. So a graph in which vertex set can be partitioned into two non-empty set X and Y. So vertex set can be partitioned. So vertex set is V, can be partitioned into two non-empty set X and Y such that, so such that every edge, okay, every edge will have one end. So every edge, of graph, okay, has one vertex. So every edge of a graph, okay, has one end vertex, in X and other end vertex in Y. And other end vertex in Y. So see one example. So what we are saying, a vertex set can be partitioned into like X union Y, okay? And X and Y are empty. So the meaning of partition is this. Such that you take any edge, so like this. So one you will find here in X and other one is Y. So for example, so consider this graph. So like you can join here, like this. So this is a bipartite graph. You can say V1, V2, V3, V4, V5. So X you can write as V1, V2, V3, and Y we can write as V4, V5. So you can check any edge will have one end in X, other end in Y. So this is X set actually, this is Y set. Okay, so any vertex will have one end in X and other end in Y. So this is a bipartite graph. Bipartite graph means you will partition the vertex set into two set X and Y such that every edge will have one end in X and other end in Y. So now, so you can also write like XY. So we'll write it as bipartition of graph G. Or you can also write it like GXY. So means G is a bipartite graph. Bipartite graph. With partitions X and Y, okay? With bipartition XY. Okay. With bipartition XY. Okay, so let us discuss a few standard example. So there is one more term, complete bipartite graph. Complete bipartite graph. So it is bipartite as well as complete. So what is the meaning of complete bipartite graph? So it is a, first of all, it is a bipartite graph. So what was in bipartite graph? The vertex set can be partitioned into two sets X and Y such that every edge will have one end in X, other end in Y. And complete means actually every vertex in X will be adjacent to every vertex in Y. So you can write in definition, a graph in which vertex set, okay, so vertex set can be partitioned into two non-empty sets X and Y such that any edge in G will have any edge in G has one end in X and other end in Y. End means end vertex. Okay. So end means end vertex in Y. So what I've written here is the definition for bipartite. And the condition is, and the main condition is every vertex, okay, every vertex in X is adjacent to every vertex of Y. So what I told, this is X, this is Y. So first of all, so you know this is small X, this is small Y, this is capital X, capital Y. We partition and all the vertices in X will be adjacent to all. So for example, and the notation is actually, so it is denoted by like KMN. So means what? Actually, vertex set is partitioned into two sets. So one set will contain M number of elements, other set will contain N number of elements. So we can write it like, so KMN is complete graph with partitioned or two sets. One set will contain M vertices and other set will contain N vertices. So KMN means like graph G is KMN, K in suffix MN. So means cardinality of set X is M and cardinality of set Y is N. For example, if I make K 2-3, suppose, so we have X will contain two vertex and Y will contain three vertex. So what do you know? Every vertex, every edge will have one end in X. So this is X, okay, and this is Y. So first of all vertices in X is adjacent to all vertices in Y. So in here, adjacent means there must be an edge, so you can join here. Okay, so we have two vertex and both are adjacent to here. All three, this, yes. So all three . So this is the K2-3. Okay, what about K3-3? So K3-3 means we have three vertex here and three vertex here. Each will be adjacent to the other. Like this. So this is the K3-3. Okay, so simple bipartite graph, we can define other way, like in short definition, if you want to write. So complete bipartite graph. So we have defined notation GXY for the bipartite graph X, bipartite graph G, in which we partition the vertex set into X and Y. So we can define complete bipartite graph as GXY such that every vertex in X is adjacent to every vertex in Y. Every vertex in Y. So every vertex in X is adjacent to every vertex in Y. Okay. And we call GXY as KMN. So again, I'm writing cardinality of X is M and cardinality of Y is N. So next we have the term star. So what is the meaning of star in a graph? So star actually is a bipartite graph in which one of the partite set will have only one vertex. So we can define it like it is a bipartite graph GXY such that with either X contains only one vertex or Y contain only one, or it is a, not end. Okay. So any one of them can contain only one vertex. So for example, so you say X has only one vertex, suppose V1, and Y you can take more than one. So you can suppose V2, V3, V4, if I take, and it is a bipartite graph. Okay. So it is the V1. Let us say V2, V3, V4. So like you can say V2, V3, V4. So it is a bipartite graph. So V1 will have edge with V3, V4, and V5 like this. Or you can take more vertex if you want to take here V5 also. So V5 we can take here and you join it. So this is a star. So name the graph is the star actually. So it will be something like you can write like it is a GXY such that, so GXY means a graph which the vertex set is partitioned into two sets X and Y. So like X set will be something of the form V1 and Y set will be of the form V2, V3 and so on up to Vn, like this you can write. Okay. So definition is a bipartite graph. So here I have written this GXY means a bipartite graph. So a bipartite graph with either X contains only one vertex or Y contains only one vertex. So next we have what is a path? What is a path in a graph or path graph? So path graph we define is the vertices of graph. So vertices of graph can be arranged in a linear sequence such that, so vertices of the graph can be arranged, or you can say labeled. So you can label the vertices as like V1, V2, V3 and so on, or 1, 2, 3 and so on, in a linear sequence such that two vertices are adjacent if and only if they are consecutive. They are consecutive. Okay, so what we say? So in a graph, you arrange the vertices in ascending order or a linear sequence, the sequence 1, 2, 3, or V1, V2, V3, and so on, such that two vertices are adjacent if and only if they are consecutive. So for example, let me verify this. So suppose this is a graph. So you see, you first label the vertices in a sequence like V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, V6. Now what they say, we call it a path graph if you first arrange the vertices in a linear sequence. So we arrange it V1, V2, V3 up to V6 such that two vertices are adjacent if and only if they are consecutive. So see, V1 and V2 are adjacent and you can see 1, 2 are consecutive number. 2, 3, this 2 and 3 are consecutive number, and V2 and V3 are adjacent. Same thing here. V3, V4 are adjacent vertices because 3 and 4 are adjacent. 3 and 4 are consecutive number. 4 and 5 are consecutive number. So V4 and V5 are adjacent. 5 and 6 are consecutive number. So V5 and V6 are adjacent vertex. And you can see V1 and V3. So they are not adjacent because 1 and 3 are not consecutive number. So that's why this is a path. And we'll denote it by Pn. So this is P6 actually, path with, So actually we write path with number of edges. How many edges it has? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we'll write it P5. P5 means path with 5 edges. Okay, so we denote it by, we denote it by PN. PN means, so what is the meaning of PN? Path graph with N edges, not vertices. Okay. So path graph with N edges, or you can say it will have, if it has N edges, then it have N plus one vertices. So you can also write like this. So since path is a simple graph, so it, like I have written a P5. So it has five edges. If you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it has six vertices. So you can see five edges and six vertices. So it will have N edges and N plus one vertices. Both are equivalent. Okay. It is a path graph. Then if I had N edge, means it has N plus one vertices. And it has N plus one vertices, means it has N edges. Okay. So now we have cycle graph. So what is a cycle? So you can say it is a path graph which first and last vertex coincides. You can write in this term, or you can define in likewise. So the vertices can be arranged in a circular order. Okay, circular order, not a linear order. So there was term arranged in a linear sequence. Okay, here we are arranging in circular order. So vertices can be arranged in a circular order such that, so the vertices can be arranged in a circular order such that, two vertices are adjacent. Two vertices are adjacent if and only if they are consecutive. So it's a circular, okay? So 1, 2, 3, 4, then again 1, 2, 3, 4, it will go like this. So for example, check this. So join this. Now we name it like V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, okay? So we arrange the sequence like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then 1. So it's a circular order. Okay. After 5, we have 1 again. And what is the condition? So vertices can be arranged in a circular order such that two vertices are adjacent if and only if they are consecutive. So two vertices are adjacent if they are consecutive. So see, 1, 2. So 1 and 2 are consecutive. So that's why V1, V2 are adjacent. 2 and 3 are consecutive. So V2, V3 adjacent, 3, 4 are consecutive. So V3, V4 adjacent, 4, 5 are consecutive. So V4 and V5 adjacent, 5 and 1 are consecutive in circular order, because after 5, you will start with 1. Since we are not talking about linear sequence, we are talking about circular. So after 5, we'll go for 1 in this case. Okay. So that's why they are consecutive. So that's why it is a cycle graph. It is a cycle. So notation is, so it will denote it by CN. So this particular graph is C5, since it has 5 edges, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah. There are 5 edges and 5 vertices. So generally it will be denoted by CN. So it is denoted by CN. CN means cycle graph with N vertices. Or you can say, currently you can say N edges. Okay, the question is, let me write one question. Is CN a bipartite graph? So think about it. CN is bipartite. So let's write, CN will start with 3. So you need at least 3 vertices, okay? So in CN, obviously N must be 3, because to make a cycle, you need at least 3 vertex. So this is C3. So question is, it is bipartite. So what was a bipartite? So in bipartite, you had, you can divide the vertex set into two parts such that every edge will have one end in X, other end is Y. But see this vertex, it has both end in same set. So that's why it is not bipartite. So what I'm saying, this C3 has three vertices, V1, V2, V3. So C3 is not bipartite. C3 is not bipartite. Why? Because if it is a bipartite, then you can divide the vertex set into two sets such that every edge will have one end in one set and other end in other set. So you have vertex set as V1, V2, V3. So how will you divide? You decide it. So what do you like to take X and what do you want to take Y? So suppose you take X V1 and Y you take V2, V3. So then you see what V2, V3 are also adjacent. So it is not bipartite. To be bipartite, every edge has one end in X and other end in Y. But you see V2, V3, this edge will have both end in Y only. That's why it is not bipartite. Or you can take other way, like X, you can take set V2 or V3, whatever way you take, it will never be a bipartite. So C3 is not bipartite, okay? C3 is not bipartite. What about C4? So if I talk about C4, so C4, you know this, is it bipartite? So we can think of, you know what, you can write the same graph as V1, V2, V3, V4, okay? Same graph we can write as, so let me write V1 here and V3 here. Why I'm writing like this? Because V1, V3 are not adjacent. And put V2 here and V4 here. Now you make the same graph in similar. So V1, V2 are adjacent. So V1, V2 make adjacent. V1, V4 adjacent, you make V1, V4 adjacent. V2, V3 adjacent. So V2 and V3 adjacent. And V3, V4 adjacent, V3, V4 adjacent. Now you see, you take this as X and this as Y. So X I am talking about vertex V1 and V3. And Y I'm talking about V2 and V4. So what do you see? We divided the vertex set into two parts. So there are four vertices. So we have taken X as V1, V3, and we have taken Y as V2, V4. And what we see? We see that every edge will have one end in X and other end in Y. You take any edge in this graph. You take any edge. So one end in X, this is X set, this is Y set. So one end in X set, other in Y set. You take any edge, you will see one edge in X set and other set in on other end of the edge in Y set. So that's why you can say C4 is a bipartite graph. C4 is bipartite graph. So what about C5? So like C3, C5 will not be a bipartite. C5, you can verify it. C5 will not be a bipartite graph. This is C5, cycle with five edges or five vertices. So you can check it. So I will write the conclusion now. C5 is not bipartite. You can try it. Because like V1, V2, V3, V4, V5. So whatever way you partition the vertex set, so in any way you partition the vertex set, you will see that so like V1 is non-adjacent to V4. So you can take one set as V1, V4, suppose you want to take like this. Then other you have to take in this V2, V3, V4. But you see V2, V3 are in same set and they are, and there is an edge between them. So you cannot partition. You try another way. So you cannot partition the vertex set into two set such that every edge will have one end in X and other end is Y. So you will not be able to do. So what do you want to say? C5 is not bipartite. So conclusion is what? Conclusion is, you can verify for more. So I'm writing conclusion. C2N is bipartite. okay, for all n belongs to natural number. So okay, n must be more than 2 because c2 is nothing. So you take here n as more than 2, more than equal to 2, okay. And c2n plus 1 is not bipartite. Not bipartite. So n, you can again say natural number. So if you take 1, it will be 3. Yeah, that will work. So odd, okay. C2n plus 1 means odd cycles are not bipartite. Even cycles are bipartite. What about Pn? So the question is Pn a bipartite graph? Can we say Pn is a bipartite graph? So like P1, if you write, so P1, it's a trivial case. So leave this, start with P2. So P2, you can take this path with two vertex. Oh, sorry. P2 means path with two edges. So we have to take three vertex. Okay. You can take like this. This. And P1 was actually path with one edge. So you can this, yeah. So this was Pn, that is fine. P1 is actually, one is the number of edges, okay? So path with one edge, and this is two edge. P3, if I write, so you can write in linear way also with three edge, or same thing like V1, V2, V3, V4. This is P3, it has three edges. If I write in other way, so V1, and you write it V2, you write it V3, and you write it V4, okay. So see, this is a bipartite. You can take X set as this, Y set as this. So every edge will have one end in X, other end in Y. So X set, you can take here V1, V3. And Y set, you can take V2, V4. So we can partition the vertex set into two sets such that every edge will have one end in X and other end in Y. So that's why it is a bipartite graph. So P3, P4, again, you can try. So I'm writing answer. Answer is yes. So Pn is a bipartite graph. So Pn is a bipartite graph. Pn is a bipartite, means path cycle or sorry, path graphs are bipartite graph for all n belongs to natural. Okay. So next, I think in the next class, I will start with the connected graphs. Okay, let's define connected graph. Then we'll, our next class will define incident analysis. So let's define connected graph. So name itself suggests connected. Okay. So if we write the abstract definition, the definition is a graph G is connected. If a graph G is connected, if for every, so for every partition, okay, for every partition of its vertex set into non-empty sets X and Y, so for every partition, okay, for every partition of vertex set into non-empty sets X and Y, there is, so there is an edge, so there is an edge with, so there is one edge, you just have to find one edge, not all, so there is an edge with one end in X and other end in Y. So what is saying, a graph will be connected if you do any partition, okay, for any partition of the vertex set, any partition you do, so you will always find an edge whose one end will be in X and other end will be in Y, right? So any graph you say, so if you partition the vertex in two parts, so you will always find one edge having one endpoint, you will find in one partite set and other in other partite set or other partition, you can say. So we are partitioning the vertex set. So for example, let's define the Pn. So this is the P3 with three edges. So you can see whatever partition you make, there are four vertices, okay? So you can take two vertices into one set and two vertices into other set. Okay, so if you take two vertex into one, like V1, V2, V3, V4, okay? So V1, V2, V3, V4. So X you can take, like you can make any partition, okay? So I'm making one, like V1, V2. And Y set you take V3, V4. So you would see that this is the edge, okay? Which having one end in X, other end in Y. You can make other partition, like X set you can take only V1. And Y set you can take V2, V3, V4. In that case, you see this is the edge. One is in X and other is in Y. Like this, you make any partition. So this is a connected graph actually. You can simply see that also. So P3 is connected graph. Okay. And similar way, if you want to define disconnected graph or not connected graph. So what is the definition of disconnected graph? So just have to write the negation statement of the definition. So for the connected graph, it was a graph is connected if for every partition of its vertex set into non-empty sets X and Y, there is an edge with one end in X and other end in Y. Now, disconnected graph. So a graph G is disconnected. So there was for every partition. So here you will write there exists a partition. If there exists a partition of vertex set into X and Y, so non-empty set X and Y, such that there is no edge, such that there is no edge, there is no edge from any vertex, okay, any vertex of X to any vertex of Y. So like you can find one partition such that one partition of vertex set, okay? So partition X union Y and X intersection Y is empty. So you can find one partition such that there is no edge from this to this. If you find just one partition, then it is disconnected graph. So for example, so let's make one graph like this is this. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. And you have graph this. So this is a single graph. Just I'm making this V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, V6, V7. So vertex set have V1, V2, total V7 elements. If you partition it like, so X set you take, I have to just find one partition such that there is no edge from of any vertex of X to any vertex of Y. So X set I defined as V1, V2, V3, V4. And Y set you define V5, V6, V7. So you see, I have taken X, Y set this, X set this, the vertices, and there is no edge from here to here. Okay. But if you define some other partition, you may get, but we have to find just one partition where you don't get any edge from the vertex set of X to vertex set of Y. Like if you define, suppose you take V1, V2 only in X and rest all V3, V4, V5, V6, V7, then you will get one edge. So that doesn't say it is a connected graph. Okay. If you get any, so you have to check for all the partitions. And if you get any one partition of the vertex such that there is no edge from vertex set of one set to vertex of other set, then it is disconnected. And if for all the partition you are getting one edge which have one end in X, other end is Y, then it is connected for every partition. If there is any partition where you don't get any edge from X to Y, then it is disconnected. Okay. So in the next class, I will define incidence matrix and adjacency matrix. So today I will stop only here. Yeah, thank you.